Hi, and welcome to QlikFix. This video will demonstrate how to use QlikCLI for SaaS to migrate apps from your on-premises QlikSense environment to your QlikSense SaaS edition. QlikCLI makes it possible for scripting and automating app migration. The tool may be installed and connected to your QlikSense SaaS tenant following the steps mentioned in this community knowledge base article. QlikCLI can also be used to connect to QlikSense on Windows via the QRS API. As with SaaS editions of QlikSense, the connection to QlikSense on Windows also requires an API key for authentication. The API key is essentially a JSON Web Token, or JWT, usually pronounced as JWT. So the first step is to have a new virtual proxy configured to accept JWT authentication. This will allow for QlikCLI to establish a trusted connection with the QlikSense server. For detailed steps on enabling and testing JWT authentication, take a look at this knowledge base article and community on how to set it up. In this video's example, however, we use the OpenSSL command found in this QlikDev page to create a certificate and private key that are used for signing the JWT. Then we create a JWT with the code sample found in this section using Node. Node.js can be downloaded from the Node.js.org website. After installing it, the JSON Web Token module needs to be installed with the following Node Package Management command. Now we can edit the provided token.js JavaScript code for creating the token. Note that the user ID and user directory attribute names, as well as the value specified for the audience attribute, are all case sensitive and need to match what is configured in the virtual proxy. Also, make sure to indicate an existing licensed user for the user ID and user directory. For the JWT encryption key, fill in the location for the private key file generated previously with OpenSSL. Now we can run this code with the following node command. The token should be created and displayed. Next, we need to create the context for the connection with the QlikSense server. Run the following command with the values for context name, URL for the virtual proxy, server type as Windows, and the API key, which is the new JWT created. Note that if an IP or alias is used in the URL, it needs to be added to the virtual proxy's list of allowed hosts. Now we switch to the newly created context with the context use command, and we are ready to run QlikQRS commands. For example, the following command will retrieve a list of apps and their IDs in JSON format. Notice that the insecure flag allows for the command to run from outside of the QlikSense server itself. Also note that we are piping the output to a JSON processing tool called JQ. JQ can be downloaded from the following webpage. Another example would be the need to retrieve app IDs for a specific stream. Adding the stream name object in the JQ command and then piping it to the select stream command can help listing the app names and IDs that were published to the specific stream. Next, we can export one of these apps. Let's first set the variable of the app ID, the exported file path, and new file name. Now we can use these variables in the following command for exporting the app. Note that the skip data flag exports the app without data. This is beneficial with larger apps since there is an upload size limit of 1 GB when importing apps to the QlikSense SaaS edition. More information on app sizing is available in the following article. We will add the flag -v to enable verbose mode and display more result information. We can see that the 200 OK is returned and that the app is successfully exported. The next step is to import the app into the QlikSense SaaS instance. First, we need to switch to the context used for the QlikSense SaaS tenant. Review the values stored in our variables. Then use the following command to import the app and store its ID to the SaaS API ID PowerShell variable. The app should now show in Cloud Hub under Explore. Keep in mind that exported apps do not contain original private sheets and have the public sheet and stories set as private as seen here. You may publish the sheets manually via Cloud Hub or use QlikCLI as in the following example. First, we review the imported app ID variable created previously. With the following command, obtain a list of sheets in the app, then set all of them to public. We can see the result in Cloud Hub and then notice that the app is still found under the user's personal space. The app may be assigned to a specific space, and many other tasks are available as well via ClickCLI. Examples for space assignment and owner changes can be found in the click.dev page shown here.
If you'd like more information, take advantage of the expertise of peers, product experts, and technical support engineers by asking a question in the Click Product Forum on Click Community, or search for answers using the new Search Unify tool. It searches across our knowledge base, Click Help, Click Community, Click YouTube channels, and more, all from one place. Also, check out the support program space. Here, you can learn directly from Click experts via support webinar, like TechSpert Thursdays, and don't forget to subscribe to the support updates blog. Thanks for watching.
Nailed it.